Greetings, YouTube. This is Fragments of Memory, your friendly neighborhood armchair philosopher. I'm sure people on YouTube are talking about this, and this is an event that has made national news. It is the there was a shooting in Colorado at the movie theater in Aurora, Colorado, I believe, and it was during a midnight showing of Batman: The Dark Knight Rises. Now, I speak of this one as a fanboy of the whole comic book, sci-fi, fantasy genre. I also speak as an armchair philosopher, and I also speak as someone who is a person of faith, a person of religious faith. Let me first go on to say that what happened in that movie theater is tragic, and it makes me wonder what type of mind that was super intelligent, super scientific, would suddenly want to attack his fellow man when he was in the sciences to help his fellow man in the neurosciences. Well, I'm sure you've heard the story. It's on the news, it's on the radio, it's in newspapers. YouTube is most people are YouTubing, talking about it and giving their 2 cents, and adding my 2 cents to the big old pot of 2 cents that are already being added. And basically, midnight showing of Batman, The Dark Knight Rises. This guy, according to news reports, threw some smoke bombs in the theater, and then he came in his armored gear and shot up everybody. Now, there were some injuries and there were some deaths. And oh my goodness. My heart broke when I heard about the 6-year-old girl who was killed. Or the one man who died defending his girlfriend. I think there were two of them. But anyway, this event has also made me look at how death is very close to us. In fact, in my faith, the religion of Islam, it teaches us that death is closer to you than the latchet of your sandal. That's a hadith according to Prophet Muhammad, peace be upon him. And during this time of Ramadan, not only should we just think about the fasting and making sure our sins are forgiven, but we should think that death can come upon us at any time, and that we need to be watchful and mindful, and we need to increase our good deeds and decrease our bad deeds. So that's just another lesson. Now, to those people that died, yes, it was tragic, but I also believe that their date of death was already set beforehand, i.e. Allah knows when a man is going to live and when a man is going to die. Like, we can't, our date of death is already set, and we don't know when our time is up. So even if you don't want to look at it from on a religious tip, you got to look at it from that life is very short, and that if there are opportunities that you need to take, please take them now, because you don't know when you won't be able to. Excuse me. I'm kind of dealing with some mucus thing, but anyway, death could come today. Death can come in an hour. Death can come tomorrow. Death can come in 5 years. It can come in 100. It doesn't matter. We're all going to die. And we need to remember that the only thing that's going to follow us is our deeds, our actions. Our faith in our deeds is what's going to follow us. It's not going to be your car. It's not going to be your house. It's not going to be any possessions you have. It's not going to be whether you were able to mack on the ladies or how good you looked. It's going to be all about your faith and your good deeds. That's just one thing. Two, this young man that had all this intellect, he could have used that intellect for good and benefited humanity, but instead he used his intellect to go kill people, to go end lives. And that, to me, is tragic. And I believe that And I'm someone who admires intellectuals, and I'm someone who thinks intellectual pursuits are a very meritorious thing. But if intellectualism, if I may use that word term, isn't coupled with God consciousness or faith, then it's worthless. And I'm someone who loves big $10 words, and I love people that are very intellectual and intelligent. But without God consciousness, without your awareness of the Creator, the one that made you, and recognizing that, all the intellectualism, all the book learning, even the life experiences you have are worthless. And excuse me. And just another thing, people forget that just because you have intellect, another lesson, just because you have the intellect to do those things doesn't mean you should. Just because you can doesn't mean you should. In fact, to have those type of abilities and to squander them on something like this is truly another tragedy in this other tragedy. So there's like many tragedies that unfold. And now we're talking about gun control laws. Now people are getting more, we want to take away the guns, or at least people are talking about the whole gun control issues. Now, me personally, I do think a person has a right to defend themselves, whether it's through learning a martial art or taking some form of self-defense, whether it's boxing or wrestling or being in tune with your law enforcement or just, hey, owning a gun yourself. But I don't think that this incident may bring more harm than good to the whole gun control debate. And so much stuff has spawned off this tragedy. And I think the best thing you should do is appreciate the life you have. Seek out the Creator, follow Him, worship Him, ascribe no partners to Him, and do all the good you can while you are still here because you are not promised tomorrow. That's my two cents on the whole situation. Take care.